Could turn any garment into flesh. One could breathe life into anything, and one could give anything a name. So after that, they introduced the wife. They said the man was a hunter, and when he was going out hunting, his wife was in the fifth pregnancy. So he gone hunting, and something strange happened. A long time passed, and he never came back home. And by that time, they did what we think is reinvent in Jamaica. I was very surprised to find this in a Nigerian story, by the way. They had the setup, and the nine nights, and the 40th night. And on the 40th night, them do exactly what we think is reinvent. Them bundle up the clothes into four parcels and go to the crossroad and throw a parcel to each cardinal point. Don't we can't go back home. Them done with that. Yes, and then the fifth child was born and turned out to also be a boy. And he observed that everybody else have a mother and a father. Because as you know, in some African societies, of which Nigeria is one, you must have a father. Your father dead, your father, biggest brother, must step in and say, I am the father. And if your mother dead, your mother, biggest sister, must say. So there is no parentlessness. So the little boy said, but something funny, I don't have a father. How it go? Well, the mother confessed that she had violated the traditions. There was nobody. A bunch of presumed the father dead. So everybody kind of vexed with her. So nobody has stepped in. And the little boy was so upset that his four older brothers set out to find out what had become of their father. And as they were walking one day, they stumbled upon what looked like bones. And the first boy said, you know, if I put them back together, that was his gift. So I put them back together. And it shaped out like a human being. Second boy said, you know, say me can make flesh door. Flesh, it looked like a man. The third boy said, I better breathe life into this thing. And the chest heaved. And the fourth boy said, I'm going to give this thing a name. I'm going to call it the most important name of mankind. I'm going to call it that. You can get up and dance. Because that's who it was.
Wow.
Went home and they had a big celebration, at the end of which the father said, when I was out hunting, I found a treasure and I want to give it to the boy who did the most to bring me back. Pasa, pasa, you know? Everybody says that. So the council of elders met and decided the fifth boy should get it, because he asked the most important question. Where me come from?
I say.
We can take that story any place we want to take it. And one of the places I take that story is, how do we remember what we were never taught? The story is called The Boy Who Remembers.
I say.
How do we remember that there is something else that we must know? Your band them say yellow, yellow, your ball out yellow, moon, moon, moon. And then one day you say, no, me something missing. Me know something else. When we say this, we sound like crazy. Because memory is something which is created in your lifetime.
I say.
But we know, say, and so it go for us. There is a place in Westmoreland called Abeokuta.
Yes.
And it is named Abeokuta by the people who go there, who done the tea from Africa,
yes,
Nigeria to be exact, and who come and remember a little village they came from named Refuge Under the Rock.
Yes, Olumo.
Exactly. And them say, well, this is it. This is my Abeokuta. I visit there quite often. Yes.
We must go.
Because I am a judge of the best competition. and there is an NHT scheme nearby. Okay. And every time I go, I pick a young person and say, why can you have your motor? The memory, the information of why gets less and less. Gets less and less. So the older people did know, and the younger one knows it. It has something to do with, oh, you know, it has something to do with Africa. It gets less and less. So how do we remember what we were not taught? So I want us to put that in the mix of whatever it is that we consider education to be. Because these are some very intellectualized answers, you know. Yeah. We want to remember spirit.
Yes.
But we've gone in a book about knowledge. And tunes.
See? The missing element.
They laugh, yes. Because after we don't talk about knowledge and tools, the people that will give us the knowledge, when they don't have no use for it, say, it's not a toolbox. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Haven't you heard that? Your education is not a toolbox. It is just for self-development. So I get self-developed and I go inside my house and lie down. No job, no day.
Exactly.
How that go? So there are some things we confront about this business of education. So the next thing is, after we finish defining, whether by spirit or by book or by relearning or by memory, ancestral memory, what does it mean to you to be educated? What does it mean to you to be educated?